Welcome back. Like me, if you've lived in Dubai for more than 6 to 7 years, then you too must have personally witnessed the growth this city has undergone. It's history happening in front of our eyes. We at High Life Dubai salute the visionaries for their forward thinking and also the actual people, the workers, who are shaping Dubai to become a world-class city. Come with me and let's take a look at Dubai's journey. Way back in the 60s, Dubai was just a sleepy little village, and the small community of people who were settled here survived on fishing and pearl diving, and later on trade and business. Dubai enjoyed profitable trade relationships and encouraged foreign merchants to set up shop here in this culture-rich town. In the mid-60s, the fortune of this city took a turn. Oil was discovered, and it was the vision and determination of our leaders that transformed Dubai from the small sleepy town it was to the wonder it is today. Pretty amazing, isn't it? Dubai today, more dashing and daring than ever before. My maha enthusiastic team and I actually got onto a seaplane and took an aerial tour of Dubai, truly in High Life Dubai style. We reached Jebel Ali and there it was, a sea-wing seaplane which took us for an aerial sightseeing tour of Dubai in this Cessna 2008 Caravan Amphibian aircraft. Within minutes, we zoomed off from the harbour into the Dubai skyline, getting a fascinating view already. From the sky, we could truly appreciate the amazing feats of modern engineering that has shaped 21st century Dubai into a modern city, a city that endeavours to build the world's biggest, brightest and the tallest. We glided over the shimmering waters of Dubai Creek. Historically, the creek divided the city into two main sections, Dera and Bar Dubai. Dera is bordered by the Persian Gulf, Sharjah and the Dubai Creek and was originally the heart of the city. The old souks, spice souks, marketplaces, traditional buildings all still exist, as does the Abra station and of course Port Said, along the Dubai Creek, which holds some of the dhows and small shipping boats. As time went by, Dera lost its importance to Sheikh Zayed Road, which was previously called Defence Road. The road forms the main artery that goes through Dubai, Abu Dhabi and Ras Al Khaimah. Dubai progressed and Sheikh Zayed Road grew by leaps and bounds. New buildings came up, each one taller and more sophisticated than the earlier. Luxury hotels found their homes along this road and Sheikh Zayed Road became the most sought-after address for any business, be it restaurants, hotels or commercial and even residential buildings. The Emirates Towers became a part of the Dubai skyline. Then we saw history rising. The Burj, the world's tallest building, rose from the ground, causing the world to take notice. And the Burj Al Arab, the super luxury hotel looking pristine white amidst the aqua blue waters. World leaders and celebrities came to experience its international yet traditional hospitality. And who can forget the famous tennis match that Andre Agassi and Roger Federer played atop its helipad. In 2006-2007, Dubai experienced a boom in the real estate industry. It went through a transformation with the liberalization of the market and sale of property to foreigners. The city saw a 24% growth in population over the past 4 years and became the fastest growing city in the world. New residential areas popped up like Emirates Hill, Springs, Meadows to keep up with the demand, and there were more like the Dubai Marina, JBR, JLT, each location more glamorous and more luxurious, offering a better standard of living to the people of Dubai. Then we flew over the iconic trilogy of the Palm Islands, a man-made island. Hollywood celebrities and business moguls have trusted in this vision and bought property here. And the grand, larger-than-life Atlantis, which is at the heart of the Palm Jumeirah. And of course, the World Island. We really did feel on top of the world. What a journey this was, ours and Dubai's. Win two gift vouchers worth 1,250 dirhams from Sea Wings for Ras Al Khaimah and Dubai Coastal Tour. Win three gift vouchers worth 1,195 dirhams from Sea Wings for Fujairah and Dubai Coastal Tour. For this extraordinary experience, visit our website.
We wanted to give a tourist experience. We're selling experience, and from what I can say, we exceed expectations. People come off the airplane absolutely delighted with the experience. What gave me the idea? I just have a passion for this part of the world. There are so many things to see. And I personally have seen Dubai grow from a small city to what it is today, moving towards being one of the world's mega cities. Looking at Dubai from the air, you can see what you can't see from the road, from the highway. You see all the developments joined up. You can see where one thing starts, another big thing ends. You can see iconic architecture. I think nowhere in the world can you see so many different examples of wonderful architecture.
It was the most exhilarating ride of my life to see my favorite malls, roads and buildings from a very different perspective. It was just awesome. The best thing about Dubai is that in spite of everything that has happened globally, this city has shown unprecedented growth. Investors still believe in the possibilities here, and Dubai's journey continues to go on. Personally, my journey continues too, as I stand in sheer amazement and watch the city evolve. We at High Life Dubai continue to bring you your city in all its grandeur and glory. The journey so far has been emotional, thrilling, exhausting, and yet so incredibly fulfilling. Thank you, my dear friends, for all your love and support that you've given us. It only makes us work harder to bring you nothing but the best. And that's why for our 150th episode, we were looking for a location which reflected our grand achievement, which is why we chose the Monarch Suite. Nothing could be more palatial and more indulgent. The Monarch Suite, the hotel's crowning glory. The Monarch Suite affords 1,130 square meters of classic luxury combined with an extensive range of state-of-the-art technology and complemented by immaculate service and spectacular views. Located on the 32nd and 33rd floor, the suite features two majlis, a dining room, a private movie theater and library, three ensuite bedrooms and an extensive outdoor area with private terrace, pool, steam room, sauna and barbecue area. The epitome of modern luxury, the Monarch Suite offers guests an unprecedented hospitality experience. No wonder the Monarch Suite was awarded the Middle East leading hotel suite. And now the Monarch Hotel is giving away weekend stay for a couple for two nights with breakfast. Afternoon tea for two in the Lobby Lounge Arcadia. One pure nature facial treatment at Mandara Spa. One Balinese massage treatment at the Mandara Spa. Three-course dinner for two in the Empire Restaurant. And by now, all of you know, to win these mind-blowing gifts, visit our website. With that, we reach the end of this momentous 150th episode. Wish you all the luck to win all these amazing gifts that we've given away on tonight's episode. See you next week on another exciting journey with your favorite High Life Dubai.